in harmony among the Fae, in a world awakened to new magic. Perhaps we should have foreseen what might be born on this rising tide. What force might awaken? A force powerful enough to twist even the eternal and the mutual Fae folk. But Gadflo, the new king of the Winter Court, surprised us all. Singular among his people, he was all that other Fae were not. Aggressive, ambitious, visionary. He had power like none we had ever seen. Terrible and deadly. Gadflo and his followers, the Tuatha De Áin, believed that a new god was to be born in the east, beneath Gadflo's crystalline fortress of Amathen.
Oh, yes.
In the name of that god, they marched to war against the young races of Amalur. Against a mortal army, no matter the power of their god, we might have been victorious. But the Fae are creatures of magic, not bound by the laws of life and death. Each Tuatha fallen on the battlefield would soon rise again, for the Fae do not know death as we do. How could we stand against such a force? For 10 years the war raged. For 10 years the armies of men and Alfar fought and died. But as our numbers dwindled, we knew that it was only a matter of time. Our fate had been written. At least, that is what we believed. Until you died.
What do you think this one is then? Alfar? Doran? Could even be a Jotun. Always a surprise, eh, Garan?
Eyes on the job, boy. Don't matter what it is. Dead's dead. And be thankful for that. All we've seen. Go on and pull back the sheet, though. It'll need to be in our report, one way or the other. One of the human women. Looks Almain to me. And in good shape. These Almain women. Wound tighter than a Varani crossbow. All right then. Make sure it goes into the report. You know he'll want all the details.
Amazing how well the body held up. Better than I've seen.
I'm just glad it's not moving.